So the sitting is resumed. The minutes of yesterday's sitting and the text adopted are available. Are there any comments? So the minutes are approved. The item on the agenda is oral question to the Commission, appointment of EBA Executive Director Farkas as AFME Chief Executive. Before I open the debate, I would like to inform you that in order to request KDI and blue cards, it will be possible to use both the standard registration and the new system allowing members to register electronically. Therefore, I invite you to always bring your voting cards. Should you wish to register for KDI, I invite you to do so starting from now, without waiting for the end of the debate. And now I open the debate, and I would like to give the floor to the author, Mr. Tank. The floor is yours.
Yes. Thank you, Mrs. President, and thank you also for explaining the KDI procedure. Appreciate it. Recently, it was announced that Adam Farkas, Executive Director of the EBA, will become the CEO of AFME. It's remarkable, right? It's astonishing. It's flabbergasting that the supervisor of that sector becomes the main lobbyist for that same sector. EBA is responsible for supervising the EU's banking sector and for setting technical standards implementing key financial regulations. This makes EBA of fundamental importance in supervising the financial sector. It also makes it a constant lobbying target for the industry. Especially AFME, with its technical expertise and focus on implementing measures drafted by the EBA, has permanent interaction with the European Banking Authority. You can just imagine my surprise when I learned that EBA's executive director will become AFME's CEO. Farkas' moves give the banking lobby privileged insight into EBA's decision-making and private access to high-level staff. As such, banks will be able to excessively influence key pieces of legislation. What is worse, this move may give the EU staff the wrong idea that if you are friendly towards the sector that you are meant to regulate, that you will be rewarded a well-paying job. In other words, this opens the door for very perverse incentives. The EU rules need to prevent this and want to prevent this. Article 16 of the EU staff regulation states that EU officials are prohibited from lobbying staff of their former institutions for a period of 1 year. As CEO of AFME, maintaining contact with the EBA is the headline of your job description. Is it realistic to expect Farkas to sit in AFME's tower, avoiding contact with his organization's main interlocutor? The staff regulations also allow the blocking of professional moves if they lead to a conflict with the legitimate interests of the institution. Is good supervision of the banking sector no longer a legitimate interest of the European Banking Authority? Because that's what's severely undermined by Farkas' move. Further, if this case of revolving doors doesn't lead to a conflict of interest sufficiently severe to block it, if Farkas is allowed to join AFME, any EU official will be allowed to join any organization. In effect, it renders Article 16 meaningless. Yesterday, we launched a petition with 58 NGOs against this case of revolving doors. Many people are disappointed, frustrated, or even outright angry. On behalf of the citizens of Europe, I therefore ask you, do you deem Farkas' move in line with the European institution's high ethical standards? Do you agree with Mr. Farkas remaining in his position until the end of January? Will you exert pressure on the EBA to change his position and block Mr. Farkas' professional move? And what will you do to put our ethical standards into practice and prevent further cases of revolving doors from undermining citizens' trust in our institutions? Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now I would like to give the floor to Commissioner Mimica. The floor is yours.
Thank you, Madam President, honourable members. The European Banking Authority is bound by the staff regulations, which contain a comprehensive ethical framework for officials of European institutions and agencies. This framework includes post-employment restrictions, which were strengthened by the 2014 staff regulations reform. The EBA Board of Supervisors is the decision-making body responsible for deciding on the and enforcing post-employment restrictions. It decided on the requirements to be imposed on Mr. Farkas for him to join the Association of Financial Markets in Europe. The Commission, European Commission representative, does not vote in the Board of Supervisors. However, the Commission is a board member and is thereby entitled to contribute to discussions at the board. In this context, the Commission pleaded for the strictest possible approach towards Mr. Farkas's departure, taking into consideration the staff regulations. The decision taken by the EBA Board of Supervisors includes restrictions on Mr. Farkas both while in service at the EBA and after leaving the EBA. With regard to restrictions while in service at the EBA, the decision taken by the EBA Board of Supervisors includes measures to cover the notice period to which he is entitled under the conditions of employment of other servants. These measures include the immediate cessation of any activities related to the preparation of EBA regulatory or supervisory policies, attendance at board meetings, external representation of EBA, and access to information outside the operations and accounting department. The restrictions also include a 3 month gardening leave, in which he ceases to exercise his role as appointing authority under the staff regulations and authorizing officer under the financial regulation. He may not be at the EBA premises except upon request of the chairperson, and he ceases to have access to EBA systems. With regard to restrictions after leaving the service, the EBA Board of Supervisors has ruled that Mr. Farkas may not engage in lobbying or advocacy vis-à-vis EBA, nor have professional contact with EBA staff for a period of 24 months. He may not contribute to the work of the Association for Financial Markets in Europe on any topics treated by him in his last 3 years of service at EBA for a period of 18 months. Therefore, restrictions are in place to prevent conflict of interest during the notice period until the effective departure of Mr. Farkas, as well as after his leaving EBA. It is the responsibility of EBA to enforce these restrictions. Thank you.
Thank you very much.